Hello viewers, and today we're going to take on Blow of the Dam, and let's get started by blowing up this dam, shall we?
Research indicates that tigers have an aversion to water. By destroying that dam, the temple will be filled with a runoff.
Flooding amount, huh? Good plan, but I don't think your bombs are strong enough to do the job.
You're correct. Fortunately, while monitoring the bug in Rajan's office, I overheard that a new autopilot attack helicopter had just arrived. It's sitting inside this truck.
Stay sharp. That dam is sure to be well protected.
So basically, the attack helicopter is inside this truck, and we're gonna use it to blow up the dam and hopefully flood Rajan out of hiding. And this one can be really damn annoying if you kind of figure out you don't know what to do, so basically try to blow up the dam as much as possible, and keep an eye on the helicopters because they can miss, but those guided missiles, they'll hit you no matter what, so you gotta keep an eye on them and try to blow up the dam. And yeah, this one can be a really annoying one, so yeah. This is a hard job to do, but if you know how to just keep an eye on the helicopters, if they get to one side, they'll shoot rapidly missiles and they'll hit you, so you gotta get rid of them too. Yeah, I know, this one's really, really evil. Okay. Oh, there's an even worse thing. And we haven't gotten to that yet. Oh, we'll get there eventually. But in the meantime, we got this job to do, so basically, yeah, that's pretty much what you have to do, so I don't know what to talk about while we're getting this job done, so, probably everybody's been knowing that Bioshock Infinite has to be delayed until February. Well, that is sad, but hey, at least it'll clear up my schedule a bit. So yeah, after this, the job's done. And we got all the jobs done for the big job.
A piece of the dam struck the chopper! It's going down! Partial flooding didn't work, so it's time to go the distance. Blowing up the temple's elephant mouth should turn this grotto into a swimming pool. I'll cover Murray from the chopper's gun turret while he pries the mouth open. Once that's done, Sly will need to walk the Cherry Bomb 500 into the throat. Then get to high ground as fast as you can. Rajan is sure to show up and be extra angry. Jump him, snag his half of the clockwork heart, and we're out of here.
So that's our game plan for Operation Wet Tiger. So yeah, basically we have to start with Murray heading to the bridges of the temple grounds. So yeah. So we're going to make a little quick jump cut right about now. There we go. And let's get Operation Wet Tiger underway.
Set up shop here and provide covering fire while you try to pry open the elephant's mouth for Sly.
Check.
And now we're going to get this little operation started by having Murray lifting up a lever so on the right side of the elephant's mouth so we can blow it up with the Cherry Bomb 500. And before we get to do that, we just have to quickly get over here and fight off some guards. Yeah, apparently guards just appear to spawn. And let's take them out, and there's going to be a few cuts here and there to fit under 15 minutes. So let's start lifting this. And then we switch back to Bentley, trying to prevent these underwater speaker bombs. to get to Murray, just shoot them down, and that's his job done, just to keep an eye on Murray in case the underwater bomb hit. Murray is in the job above. Yeah, and just make sure they don't get to the bottom, because they'll fly towards Murray. Just try to destroy them as quickly as you can. And I never have this problem when playing it all the time. I always seem to get them pretty just fine. I know, it's weird, but still. Just keep this up and the bombs will eventually go away. But the problem is, with this turret, it keeps rocketing forwards and backwards, so you're gonna have to adjust your aim in order to hit them. Either that, and then a tiny scream, was that for my recording is too small? I have no idea. So now we gotta mash all the buttons in order to lift this lever up so I can bring in the Cherry Bomb 500 and blow it up to Kingdom Come. So yeah, get this to the elephant's mouth, you just have to cross a few bridges. And we're gonna make another cut here, yeah. Yeah, I know, it's just a simple route, you can't miss it. So let's drop off and get the hell out of its blast before this place blows and floods. And you'll flood the inner part because there's good reason. And Rashawn's finally out of this hiding, out of hiding, and let's get this underway.
Black clouds and thunderbolts, my spice temple ruined. I will no longer hide while you villains destroy my hard-won empire. This place is mine. Here I am king. Come, face me, Cooper. With Clockwork's black heart, I will show you true power. You are nothing. Come face the might of Rajan, lord of these hills.
When we try to tick someone off, we really do the job.
You do seem to have quite a talent for it.
Constable Neela, slumming it with the thieves again?
That man is an illegal spice trader. He should be brought to justice.
All I'm after is the clockwork part. You help me take him down, and the bust is all yours.
Just try to keep up.
Oh, here we are getting to this section of this job. We just have to ninja-spire jump all the way to Rajan, and we have to avoid his lightning attack. I don't know how lightning is traveling down logs! Lightning does not work that way! I mean, come on! Lightning going down that way? I mean, that is on wood? How can that be? Oh, never mind, let's get quick.
Sorry. What are you doing?
Fly! I'm coming, buddy! Is it? This is the Cooper gang I've heard so much about and feared these long hours?
Murray will renew your fear.
Who's the Murray? All I see is a fat, pathetic weakling.
I might be big and not as smart as the other guys, but one thing I'm not is weak.
And so we get to the main boss of Rajan. The boss with Rajan. So we just keep wailing him away, just try to punch him 3 times, then try to get into the electric fence, and watch out for that staff of his. He can just get on the lily pad before he does his electrical attack, so you won't get any damage. And after a certain amount of damage, Rajan's going to start spamming minions, and you can use minions as weapons. Let's try to avoid Rajan when he tries his lightning move on you. Just use the minions as cannon fodder, and you can make Rajan your personal cannon to hit with other enemies. This can be hard unless you don't know what to do, but simply just keep on railing the guy until he's finally beat. You can't beat up these minions, but they're just going to keep on coming, but they sometimes produce health. If you want to get some health, just kill some minions until you get some health back, and you'd be back at full and then fighting them again. Just keep on dodging. Try to chuck Rajan or make him go to the electrical fence around this arena. It does a little more damage, and I think that does a little more damage. I'm not sure, but it could be more. I'm not sure. Just keep this up, and you'll eventually beat this boss. Just some health, and sometimes, yeah, that's basically it. Just it can be a very hard boss if you don't know what to do, and just keep this up, and then you'll eventually beat Rajan by beating him up and using your fist, your strength, and chucking him into the electric fence. Keep this up, and this boss is done. And that's the end of the episode! Yay!
Fly's gonna want this half of the Clockwork Heart safe and sound.
Happy day.
What? Neela? Throw down a ladder! Sly's hurt real bad! Can you hear me? I said Sly's hurt!
There they are, Contessa. Just as I promised. The Cooper Gang and Rajan all incapacitated.
Excellent police work, Constable Neela. Carmelita's never been able to catch the Cooper Gang.
Yet you capture them in just a few short weeks.
I never...
Really, Carmelita. Accept your defeat gracefully.
Actually, Contessa, there's a good reason Inspector Fox never caught the Cooper Gang. She's been in league with them the whole time. Liar! Prove it! This is a photo of Carmelita dancing with Sly Cooper on the night the Clockwork Wings were stolen. I was dancing with Cooper.
You certainly seem very familiar in this picture. Men, place Inspector Fox under arrest.
Forget you, Neela. Don't think I won't.
Such a pity when an officer falls from the light.
Yes, indeed.
I can't believe it! That double-crossing cockney liar!
Though statistically improbable, I had to face the facts. Neela had betrayed us, my teammates were captured, and I was all alone. While intellectually inferior, Sly and Murray had always been a rich source of sociological interest. The long walk out of the jungle gave me time to reflect. And with each passing step, my sense of isolation grew. Shockingly, my comrade's absence had a profound emotional effect on me. This was it. This was the true test of friendship. Upon reaching the van, my resolve was hardened. I had to save my friends. But first things first, I had to learn how to drive a stick shift.
So yeah, everything just went from bad to worse. Now our gang is in prison, and now we have to deal with episode 4.